Well, this morning we've got news that your kids will be happy to hear. A growing number of schools across the country are banning homework. Concerns among parents and educators over how students should spend their free time have driven home schools to opt out of homework altogether. But is this the right move? Here to discuss is Dr. Psychologist Jonathan Fader, Hispanic market expert and mother, Lili Gil Valletta, and freelance writer, Jennifer Wallace. Nice to see all of you this morning. Let's talk
good some to see
parenting
you,
this morning. All right, getting rid of homework. You're on the side of this. Extreme homework, you say get rid of it, Jonathan.
Well, listen, I say get rid of extreme homework.
Well, what's extreme homework? This sounds like drinking Mountain Dew and extreme sports.
That's the kind of homework I did back in the day.
What is extreme homework?
So when we think about homework, right, there's usually the general rule is 10 minutes per grade is what we think. So if you're in first grade, 10 minutes. If you're like a 12th grader or a senior, 2 hours is the max. And the reason for that is if you have extreme homework, it doesn't really teach kids anything. What we know is more content doesn't really do anything. What we really need to do is teach kids how to regulate their behavior. So just enough homework to help them to learn how to learn, not just to focus on the content that they're learning.
Do you think it's a smart move, Jennifer, to ban it?
No, I don't. And I don't know when homework became the enemy and a punishment. And I think it's a bad message to send children. So I agree with you. I think moderation is the key here.
What about the reversing of homework? We've heard, you know what, doing homework in class where there's actual discussion and cooperation, when you're actually at home, then you're not doing homework. You're I don't know, sort of contextualizing the stuff you learned in school, maybe reading or adding more to what you took away from class.
Right. I think the case for homework is not just as good for the kids to have with moderation that self-regulation and the discipline of accountability, but also for the parents. It's very easy for us as parents sometimes to disconnect from the curriculum of what's going on in the classroom. This could be also an opportunity with moderation for it to be a point of discussion of what they're learning, so you get involved in that learning process as an extension in the house.
Another story that was making headlines this week about generation helplessness. How are kids able to do anything? Now, I always think about it, you know, if we had the zombie apocalypse, would these kids be able to actually know how to go to wood shop, do different
things?
They'd
be taking some pictures of some zombies.
Yeah.
Though. They'd be posting really good zombie pictures.
Yeah.
Selfie with the zombies.
Look at this story. What can children do confidently? Right now, 57% of them work better on a mobile phone than they do other things. They tie their shoelaces, 53% of them, and 49% of them can tell time. So people know how, kids know how to use a mobile phone more than they know how to tie their shoes. Are you troubled by this?
It's very scary. You know, I was looking at some numbers, and from ages 0 to 8, 89% of kids in this country are using mobile devices. That's up from 38% in 2011. And the iPhone was first introduced in 2007. We're now starting to see the 7-8-year-olds, preteens, that are going to be of this generation. And you're seeing different behaviors because you're not interacting with real people.
But, Jennifer, what's the problem? Come on. An iPhone, really? Is it destroying our generations?
Well, I don't think it's the iPhone or the iPad that's destroying it, but the parents and the lack of regulation.
Bingo.
We can't blame technology.
I totally
blame
agree.
The parent. If I left, you know, it's just like if I left Oreos all over the house, my children would binge on them.
Right.
So
they
I think,
need them all.
Yes,
exactly.
We need a technology diet.
If you don't limit the kids' time with electronic devices, you're in trouble.
Yeah, like, I mean, look, Steve Jobs is quoted to say that he limited technology in his household. Everything in moderation. Aristotle was right, right? The idea is that the phone adapts to you. Your shoelaces aren't going to adapt to you. And so kids need to learn, just like homework, self-regulation. And I totally agree. It's a parent's, it's our job, it's as parents, to teach our kids how to moderate. Banning it is no good, but it's teaching them how to limit it and to use those skills of self-regulation so they can do that in all things in life.
Mm-hmm. Great discussion, guys. We appreciate it. Jonathan, Lili, and Jennifer, great to see all of you.
Good to see you, Clay.
Thank you.